Hey everyone, my name is Andres, and in this video, I'm going to go over the basics of styling nameplates with Plater, and then I want to show you how you can take your plates to the next level with scripts and mods. My hope is to give you the tools you need to build your own nameplates, but I'll also show you how to import profiles if you want to borrow another player's settings. I'm also working on a video right now where I compare several profiles to find the best one, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. Alright, so according to Plater's author, there are over 500 settings in Plater. I'm not going to go over every single one in this video, but I do want to highlight some of the most important ones and show you how scripts and mods work. So to get started, you can open the Plater options by typing /Plater into your chat box. You can adjust the size of this window by moving the scale slider in the top left. As a pro tip, you can also right click on any of the sliders in Plater's options and then type a number in and then press enter. The first options tab is for general settings. Anything you change here will apply to all of your nameplates. In the bottom left, you can change the sliders to adjust the width and the height of your health bars. To change the overall scale of your nameplates, including the cast bar, you need to adjust the fine-tune scale slider, which you can find under the level and strata tab. Another important setting back on the general settings tab is the stacking option. You can make your nameplate stack by clicking the checkbox for stacking nameplates, and this will make it so that your nameplates don't overlap, which is really important when you're fighting several enemies. I also recommend that you check the Use Blizzard's Nameplate Alpha box. This will apply transparency to enemies that are hidden behind walls and will keep your UI cleaner. Changing the Occluded Unit Multiplier will adjust the amount of transparency. I typically like to set this to around 0.2 or 20%. You can also change the overall transparency for all nameplates with the third column on the General tab. You can find this underneath the alpha amount for the enemies and then also the alpha amount for friendly units. The last major setting on the general tab in retail that I want to highlight is show resources on target. When you enable this, it will add combo points and other resources to your target's nameplate. If you're using Plater in TBC, you'll actually need to turn these combo points on by first selecting the modding tab and then enabling the combo points mod. Okay, so in addition to the general settings tab, you can also use the personal bar, enemy NPC, enemy player, friendly NPC, and friendly player settings to customize health bars further. For example, if I select enemy NPC, I can change the size of the bars with the sliders at the top of the second column. This will override the width and the height that I chose on the general settings. You can also change the appearance and location of the text on your nameplates. To adjust the enemy name settings, you change the options under NPC name text. Switching the anchor dropdown will move the location of the name. I personally prefer to put the names of mobs on the top left, so let me do that real quick. I also like to adjust the percent health text shown in the bar by disabling the health amount and then by increasing the size of the percent. There are a handful of other options here you can play around with, so feel free to go to town. Alright, let's move on and talk about buff and debuff icons. By default, buffs and debuffs rest on top of the health bar. Since I moved the enemy name, I now need to adjust my buffs. To do this, you can click on buff settings to see the current location. And we can clearly see that they're covering up the enemy name. If I change the slider for the Y offset in the second column to about 12, then I should be able to see the enemy name again. I also want to change the offset for my combo points as well. I can do this by going to the personal bar tab, and then by changing the Y offset on target to 19, and offset if buff is shown to 30. Now, when I put this all together, I can see the enemy name, the combo points, and the buffs. One of the other nice things about the buff icons in Plater is the ability to set special buffs. This will cause crowd control, debuffs, or any aura you choose to appear to the side of the frame. To set this up, click on Buff Special, and then enter the name of what you want to track. If I put in Sunfire as an example, you can see that it moves my Sunfire debuff from the top of the frame to the side. If you find that Plater is showing too many buffs on the nameplate, you can actually remove them by adding them to the blacklist under the buff tracking tab. Plater does a good job overall and you shouldn't need to do much blacklisting, but the option is there if you want it. As a shortcut, you can also add special buffs or blacklist buffs underneath the buff list tab. This will show all of the buffs and debuffs you've encountered recently, so you can just simply scroll through that list and then click add to blacklist it or add it to a special buff. There are a lot of other customizations you can make to your nameplates. If you click on the NPC colors tab, it will add a drop-down menu that you can use to change the color of a bar based on the name of an NPC. You can add an NPC to this list by changing the drop-down underneath the health bar or by targeting a unit and then typing /Plater, /add into chat. You can also navigate through a list of spells under Cast Colors to change the color of cast bars based on spell names. This can be a great way to highlight dangerous abilities and ones that need interrupting. You can adjust the size and colors of your cast bars overall with the cast bar settings. I would recommend that you click the toggle cast bar test on when you're trying to make changes. This just makes it easier to see what each option does. Honestly, I don't do too much adjusting of the cast bars or things like NPC colors, but they are pretty fun options to play around with. In the rest of the video, I want to talk about the scripting and modding tabs. When I first started using Plater, the script and mod tabs were intimidating. However, after diving into them deeper, I was blown away with the types of things that are possible. So let's talk about how scripts and mods work, why you would want them, and how to get them. Scripts are code that are run based on a specific trigger like a cast or an NPC name. This allows you to treat some nameplates different than others. For example, if I click on the scripting tab and I select the cast very important built-in script, you can see a list of the spells to use as triggers. Whenever one of these spells are cast, the cast bar will change colors and begin to shake to let me know something dangerous is coming. If I attack this tanking dummy, he will use an ability called Uber Strike on me. I could add it to the very important triggers to change the appearance by typing it into the Add Trigger box and clicking Add. All right, so now that I've done that, let's attack this guy again. Now, when he casts Uber Strike, the nameplate shakes and begins to glow. You can remove triggers from the list by clicking the X on the right side of the spell name. In addition to spell triggers, you can also add triggers for buffs and debuffs. If you look at the buff alert script, it will add a rotating red box around auras in the list. If I add Sunfire to this list, you notice that my debuff for Sunfire now has a red glow around it. The last type of script trigger is for unit frame. An example of this is the explosive affix script, which changes the color of the cast bar for explosives in Mythic Plus. So now you might be wondering, if we can do all of this with scripts, why do we need mods? Well, mods are more generic code adjustments that apply to all nameplates, and they don't rely on triggers. So anything you change through a mod will apply to every nameplate, not just specific units or casts. One example of this is the Execute Range mod. This adjusts all your health bars to change the color when you can begin casting execute abilities. Adjusting mods is a little more intimidating than scripts, and requires some comfort with some basic coding. Changing mod settings is typically done by clicking on Constructor underneath the Add Hook section. For instance, if I wanted to change the execute color, I would click on the Execute Range mod, then on Constructor. Within the code on the right, I can look for something that looks like a color to change. Any lines with the double dash in dark gray are comments to help guide me. Reading through the comments tells me that I can change the color by name or with other methods like hex color codes. As a pro tip, if you type /plater colors into chat, it will show you a list of every color you can use in Plater. To change my execute color, I could then change it from green to something like crimson. After making that change, I just need to click on save in the bottom, and now the mod is updated. In most cases, you won't need to change code in your mods, but I thought it'd be helpful to give you a little taste of what goes into building them. If this video is helping you out, make sure to slam that like button so other players can find this video and learn the ins and outs of Plater. Okay, so far we've only looked at the built-in scripts and mods. You can also find additional ones by going to wago.io and clicking on Plater nameplates on the left side. From there, you can select from a large set of categories for Plater. I'm going to go ahead and click on the Plater mods. You can see there are several mods for things like Mythic Plus and Target Arrow Indicators. I'm actually going to grab the Extra Quest Icon mod because I just like having that exclamation point on the side of my nameplate. To import this into Plater, you just need to click on Copy Plater Import String, go back to the Modding tab, click on the little document with the down arrow icon, and then paste that string. The icon is a little far off to the side because the default selection area for the nameplates is pretty wide. Luckily, you can change this by going to the Advanced tab, and then by selecting Always Show Background. If I adjust the enemy box selection width, it will move the quest marker closer to the health bar. In addition to importing scripts and mods, you can also import a full profile of settings into Plater. From the same Plater home screen on WAGO, click on Plater Profiles. If I change the sword options to stars, I can see which profiles are the most popular overall. Let's grab this Better Pixel Perfect profile and copy the import string. Back in the Plater options, click on Profiles, and then Import Profile. Give it a new name, and press OK. This will load all of the profile settings, including scripts and mods. In this video, you learned the basics of changing nameplate appearance, scripts, and mods in Plater. I'll leave a link to the profile I built for this video in the description if you want to play around with it. If you want to see how Plater compares to other nameplate add-ons, check out this video next.